Namaskaram. In this Agni Initiative video, we are going to explore all about groundnuts and why having this on a daily basis can do wonders to your health and well-being. So first of all, groundnuts is considered a complete meal by itself. And there have been yogis who have completely gone on a groundnut diet. So they just survive with only groundnuts. So it has all the necessary ingredients to sustain life. You need not go on a complete groundnut diet, but at least if you can have groundnuts on a daily basis, it can do a world of good. So how do you consume these groundnuts or peanuts? The best way to consume this is by soaking it in water overnight or at least for a minimum of 6 hours. This removes certain pitta content. In Ayurveda, we have something called as the pitta, and soaking these groundnuts overnight helps in removing this pitta content. Otherwise, it can lead to rashes or nausea. So it's best if you can soak this in water and then have this. You can even have it along with the skin. So this is the best way to have, so that you can take in as much nutrition as possible from the groundnuts, which can be lost if you are roasting or frying it. So soaking also enhances the nutritional content and increases the phytonutrients present in the groundnuts and also the digestibility in the system. So it's best if you can have this while soaking it overnight or for a minimum of 6 hours. Now, this is something everybody at home can have. Even if you have children at home, even they can have. And it's best if you can have it before you start your cooked food. So in the yogic meal system, we always start with the raw food first, followed by the cooked food. So when you're starting with the raw food, you can start with groundnuts and then move on to salads, fruits. And then after you finish all your raw food, then you can move on to cooked food. So that is the correct order to have groundnuts. If you come to the Isha Yoga Center, you'll notice that they always serve groundnuts, at least a handful of groundnuts first thing. When they serve you brunch in the morning, they always start with groundnuts. So this is the best way to have it. You can also boil the groundnuts and have it. That is also okay. You can still do that. But it's better to have it raw, which is like soaked. Or if you wish, you can boil it and even add it to salads or sprouts or even your sanjeevani kanji or other porridges which you are making. You can even add it to them and have it. So that's also fine. But especially if you are traveling outside and if you wish to carry something along with you, then this could be a good snack. If you wish to carry groundnuts, it could give you adequate source of protein. And we have seen a lot of people, they worry so much about their protein content, where like they try to take protein shakes, protein powders and other supplements just to increase the intake of protein. So instead of that, you can have groundnuts, because groundnuts are a very rich source of protein and you can even carry them around and have this. So nuts like groundnuts, cashew nuts, these are very high sources of protein. So you can have them instead. And it's not necessary for you to take supplements or protein powders, which are artificial sources of protein. See, you don't need too much protein for the system. The body is just requires a small percentage of protein, and this can very easily be taken care of by eating groundnuts, sprouts and other raw foods in sufficient quantities. You can very easily take care of this requirement. So how much of groundnuts to have? You can at least have one handful of groundnuts or 2 tablespoons of groundnuts per meal. So that's something which you can do. If you wish, you can even have more. Especially those of you who are underweight, you can have more groundnuts because it can help you put on weight. So try to see if you can include this in your daily diet. And we'll also include a short video along with this, which will follow after this, where you can even see how you can soak the groundnuts if you've not done this before. It's a simple short video. which will show you how you can soak the groundnuts. You can even soak it in warm water, or even in normal water you can soak it overnight and then rinse it in the morning and have it along with the skin. Similarly, if you are having almonds, that's also something which can be taken. You can also do the same process by soaking it overnight and then having it in the morning. So see if you can include this on a daily basis in your diet, and let us know how you are incorporating this. Namaskar.
If you eat food and your body feels very agile and alive, that means it's good food, body is liking it. If you eat something, it feels dull, that means it's not liking it, it's having difficulty with it, that's why it feels dull.
Namaskaram everyone, hope you guys are doing good. So just like Mukulana said, having peanuts like this, soaking it and having it is the best way. But if you are someone like me who has had roasted peanuts his entire life, then this is gonna be hard. This taste is something that I'm not still used to, and it's so hard. You know, I do so much sadhana sometimes and I think, okay, I've broken so many limitations, and then I get a handful of soaked peanuts and I'm like, how am I gonna finish this? I don't like this stuff. So definitely guys, do try it out. One thing that I personally do to have soaked groundnuts is there's a recipe that Traptiyakka has given of groundnut banana shake. So in that way, I mix groundnut with banana, add a lot of honey and then drink it up. So I do not know whether it's the best way. The best way should be the way that Mukulana said, but I feel that is the second best way. But one experience that I would like to share about having peanuts is when I used to do Shivanga sadhana. At that time, we were not supposed to have anything in the morning other than a handful of soaked groundnuts. Yes, it was very hard for me to, you know, have it. It's just raining and I'm noticing it. It's very hard, you know, for me to have it. But our first meal will be at, you know, 12 p.m. during the Shivanga sadhana. But early morning doing all the sadhana, having these groundnuts, and throughout the entire day, I never used to feel hungry. Yes, I grew up a little bit lean, but that's because maybe I didn't have so much groundnuts. But I never felt tired, I was fully on, and I think this stuff works. Like a lot of people ask me about protein, where can I get my daily source of protein if I'm going vegetarian. So if you're going vegetarian, definitely you can have this. So guys, definitely try this out, and you know, let Mukulana know, tag Agni Series, follow him on his Instagram page, follow him on his YouTube page. He definitely does lives and all, so definitely follow there. So hope you guys have a great time, and do check out his Ahar program also. So I just want guys show you the rain. Yep, it's raining. I don't know whether it's seen, but it's raining nicely here in Kerala. So guys, hope you have a great time. Take care. Namaskaram. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Leave a like or dislike, whatever, but like is best. And yes guys, and also one more update, like I do daily logs, like daily what I'm doing on my Twitter. Like Twitter has this option of putting out audio content like in small clips. So if you want daily updates from me, you can follow me on Twitter. Instagram also I do, but daily updates are there on Twitter. So it's totally up to you guys. So take care. Namaskaram.